What was maybe the biggest thing you took from your loss to Lomachenko? Is there anything you learned from that fight that moving forward you could bring into the ring?
Consistent, quickness, smartness. He taught me a lot. I'm still learning. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited for Saturday.
I know you're friends with Tevin Farmer, right? And he has a championship bout in the future coming up soon. How do you see him and yourself matching up with the other champions at 130? Even guys like Gervonta Davis and stuff like that.
Like I told him before we even became a name, I told him, Ted, we gotta take over.
Yeah.
And we slowly been taking over. And it's great, man, because he's my brother and all, and this is just like, we actually living the dream. Mm. I don't take it away from any fighter. But at the end of the day, me and him got a vision, and we just want to continue doing the best that we can in boxing until we get old, right?
This Gamboa, your come forward style, is this something that's going to end in a knockout? Is that something that we can expect on Saturday?
Yeah, I'm hoping myself for early knockout, so it'd be a quick day. I'm ready to go 10 rounds. I'm excited to be fine combo.
Let me get your prediction and opinion on Lomachenko and Rigondeaux. If you could break that down for me.
Don't know much about Rigo. He's a talented fighter, I know. It's going to be a great fight. Two Olympians going against each other in a professional level. It's exciting to watch. Predictions? You really can't say, man. It's two Olympians.
Okay. Even having had been in the ring with Lomachenko, it's hard to say?
Yeah, it's hard to say, man, because at the end of the day, I don't know what Rigo brings. I haven't been in the ring with Rigo.
Okay.
I know with Lomachenko, but I don't know anything about Rigo. But I think it's going to be a great fight and something special for the fans.
Okay. Being in the ring, how big is Lomachenko for the 130-pounders, being that Rigo is going up in weight class? Will size be a difference in this?
I don't know, man. I mean, I know myself that I fought people, twice my weight class. Mm. And I came at 130 pounds. And I ended up knocking them out. So I really, honestly, I don't know. I know that I'm told that Rigo got power. I've taken shots from Lomachenko. Lomachenko, doesn't really have power. But he's consistent.
Mm.
He will wear you out. And, that's about it, man.
Have you ever sparred Tevin?
Yeah.
All right. So, as far as their slickness and just overall reflexes, are they comparable at all, or is Lomachenko a step above everybody?
No, to Tevin, nobody got Tevin's slickness.
Okay,
Tevin
so
a different level.
All right, so he actually has a level above Lomachenko as far as the slickness and.
Tevin, good man. He does some stuff. He'd be like, you have to stop sparring because what he did.
Yeah.
Like what you just do?
Yeah.
Like, but Loma is more the foot that he has. He's so smooth with everything. And, Tevin is just the upper body and footwork. And he just, it's two different styles.
Okay, two different styles. This fight is a fight, these guys go back and forth on Twitter. I know Tev's your boy. But if you could talk about him versus Tank, and how would that fight look if that was to happen?
I think Floyd Mayweather should make it happen.
Okay.
And for the right money, at the end of the day, this is a business.
Yeah.
I don't care what anybody says. We all look for a nice check.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, it got to be for the right money. And it should happen. But should it happen now?
Yeah.
I don't know. Because they're building it.
Yeah.
And I think that will be a great fight in the future.
Mm. All right, man. Well, hey, man, I appreciate your time, man. Appreciate your boxing mic.